I'm back, Gaia.
Hello, Aloy. What would you like to discuss?
What can you tell me about Demeter?
Demeter sows, fertilizes, and tends to plant life.
So once I bring it back, all the blight out there will start to get better.
While permanent restoration requires the abilities of Hephaestus, I may be able to improve conditions in the region for a while. However, a word of warning. Like Aether and Poseidon, Demeter's response to my query was highly irregular. Alone and frightened, it may have taken measures to assure its security.
Okay, I'll keep my guard up. The missing subordinate functions. What can you tell me about them?
Artemis rewilded the Earth with a variety of animal species. Eleuthia was responsible for gestating, nurturing, and acculturing a new generation of human beings. Apollo was tasked with preserving, organizing, and disseminating vast archives of human knowledge and cultural achievements. Unfortunately, all archived Apollo data was purged on the 2nd of February, 2066, by order of Ted Pharaoh.
Pharaoh, huh? I really hate that guy.
Understandable. He appears to have been pathologically narcissistic, impulsive, and unstable.
All three of the missing functions have already served their purpose, or were prevented from doing so. Do you still need them?
Restoring their remaining elements would increase my heuristic processing density, empowering my overall function. Unfortunately, as we now know, they are in the possession of Far Zenith. Attaining them in the short term is very likely impossible.
I guess our best shot at recovering them is by taking over the Zenith base. But we'll need Hephaestus and a bunch of combat machines to do that.
Correct.
So, Poseidon, what do we know about it?
Poseidon controls the organic and chemical composition of water resources. Once it is restored to me, I may be able to improve conditions in the regional watershed. But I must warn you, like the others, Poseidon is lost and frightened. It may have taken measures to protect itself.
I'll be careful. So, once Hephaestus has been recovered and merged, you'll regain the capacity to mass-produce machines at cauldrons around the world.
Yes. And to program their behavioral routines. Or even control them directly.
So you could build an army of machines. Attack the Zeniths and take them out.
It is in my nature to take any and all necessary steps to preserve life on Earth, human life above all. So yes. Once I have been empowered with the capacities of Hephaestus, I could design, build, and command such an army. Given the nature of the Far Zenith threat, doing so may be our only option. I must admit, however, that I have misgivings about using such technology to kill, no matter how aggressive the enemy.
That's good. It means you have a conscience. As Elizabeth intended.
Indeed.
You mentioned that the superstorms have subsided. Is that Aether at work?
Yes. Thanks to Aether's capabilities, weather patterns in the local region should mostly stabilize for the time being.
Well, that's a relief. Be nice not to have to fight my way through a storm anymore.
I will continue to stabilize the atmosphere for as long as I can.
Why did Aether take up residence in an ancient war museum?
As with the other subordinate functions, Aether needed to install itself on a processor with adequate storage and power. One in the museum appears to have been sufficient, given that the holographic displays were still active.
So Aether was assured it could stay for as long as it needed to?
Correct. Though it is curious that it chose a place surrounded with the ancient ruins of aircraft.
Maybe it also felt at home there. Beta believes the Zeniths want to use the terraforming system to wipe out life on Earth. Start over. So they can build it how they want.
Further supporting our hypothesis.
But why? Given their technology, they could wipe out the tribes of the world by easier means. And if they're the same people who left Earth 1,000 years ago, wouldn't they want the biosphere to be as it was?
It is likely they adjusted to different planetary conditions in their colony on Sirius. They may be trying to recreate that environment here.
Turning Earth into a new Sirius. Their own personal playground. So the Zeniths are the same people who left Earth. Physically immortal. How'd they figure it out?
From what we know of Far Zenith, it is plausible that prominent geneticists and engineers were offered a place aboard the Odyssey in exchange for their expertise. Given enough time, technology, and resources, any challenge can be overcome.
Like how Minerva eventually generated the deactivation codes for the Pharaoh Plague.
Exactly.
The Zeniths. Gerard, Eric, Tilda, Verbena. Beta said they were some of the most powerful people on Earth. Do you know anything about them?
Unfortunately, no. My personal database is limited to those who worked on Zero Dawn. Additionally, it appears Far Zenith was quite secretive about their members. Only one, Oswald Dahlgard, was ever publicly known.
Right. He was the spokesperson back at their old launch facility.
What we can conclude from your and Beta's experiences is that the Zeniths are ruthless in pursuit of their goal. To protect life on Earth, they must be stopped.
The extinction signal didn't just wake Hades. It made every subordinate function self-aware. Why?
I have wondered this myself. So far as I can tell, Hades was the sole target, and the partial sentience imparted to other subordinate functions was incidental.
A signal that precise would require thorough knowledge of the system. How could the Zeniths know that?
From the records on your focus, it appears Far Zenith had an informant during the development of Zero Dawn.
Hank Shaw. He was supposed to steal a copy of the system for Far Zenith, but Elizabeth and Travis Tate caught him first.
Yes. It is likely Far Zenith acquired knowledge on the system's design through him, despite his failure.
So from what Beta told me, I guess we can assume the Zenith's technology is powerful in all sorts of ways, right?
Yes. As your encounters with them amply demonstrate, they appear to make extensive use of robotic servitors. Further, they seem to be equipped with some kind of protective energy field that shields them from harm.
They seemed indestructible, but that weapon the rebels used stripped their shield somehow.
Throughout history, Every defensive technology has eventually been defeated by an offensive counterpart. While we lack the anti-shielding weapon, were I to absorb Hephaestus and utilize it to create a large force of combat machines, no shielding could withstand such an assault indefinitely.
So there's hope.
Always.
So, I guess Beta's here to stay. I gave her a focus. Told her to talk to you to see if she can help. She's... not what I expected.
What were you expecting?
I don't know. Someone more helpful, I guess. And less pessimistic.
It is true, she overestimated our progress. However, it is also worth noting that her confidence in your abilities emboldened her to escape the Zeniths.
I guess so.
Give her time. She may yet come around.
How's Catalo doing?
I have detected that the loss of his arm still deeply pains him. In an effort to remedy this, I have discussed a potential solution with him. I believe he will want to fill you in on the details.
A solution? I'll check in with him when I can, then. How are things around here?
Zoe has been studying the morphology of her land gods in an effort to understand their sickness. Without the abilities of Hephaestus, I am unfortunately unable to correct their programming. However, Zoe and I are hopeful we will find an alternative way to heal them.
Well, keep at it. Varl and Zoe seem to like spending time together.
Indeed. While studying old world data, Zoe discovered references to a dietary lifestyle known as vegetarianism. She appreciated the similarities with Utaru practices and encouraged Varl to try out this lifestyle.
And how did that go?
I believe they have agreed to disagree.
How's Errand handling things?
He is becoming increasingly accustomed to use of the focus. After an initial incident.
What did he do?
He unfortunately crushed his first focus as he attempted to affix it to his temple. Amongst a number of Osiram curses, I believe he also blamed the focus for being dainty. He has given repeated assurances that it will not happen again.
Well, good thing we have a lot of extras, I guess. Gaia? What was Elizabeth like?
Her presence is interwoven with my memories. The moment I came online, she was there. We exchanged greetings, names, then set to our task. It was the first of many conversations. I enjoyed being in her company, listening to her stories. She was my creator, my guide.
Your friend.
Yes. When I reviewed the data on your focus, I was saddened to learn of her fate, though I am glad she made it home. I deeply wish she did not have to be alone.
She was okay with that. She gave all of herself. The only one who could. Thanks, Gaia. So, Project Zero Dawn. The greatest minds in the world, all working to build the terraforming system while the Feral Plague devoured the planet. What was it like?
Personnel worked in rotations, at all hours of the day. Resources and technology were secured from across the world. Within a month of the project's conception, I was launched and began my education. Elizabeth encouraged me to spend time with the rest of the Zero Dawn staff. She said it was important to experience many personalities and perspectives to aid in my emotional development.
What were they like?
Scared, hopeful, determined. They were hurtling toward technological achievements on a scale never before attempted. I owe everything to their dedication.
So the Hades Proving Lab, where I found the Gaia Kernel. It used to be a Pharaoh research facility?
Yes. Prior to appropriation by Zero Dawn, the facility was used to engineer and test advanced computer viruses. It appears to have been one of many research initiatives by Pharaoh Automated Solutions.
I guess it wasn't enough to build automated killing machines. He wanted viruses to infect them with, too. So, a while back, before the battle at Meridian, I went into Banuk territory. I discovered another AI there. One not related to Zero Dawn. Cyan. It was created to oversee operations for a volcanic stabilization project, and it spent the last 1,000 years in isolation. I'm guessing you didn't know about it?
No. From the data on your focus, it seems that Cyan was cut off from the outside world, an effort by its creators to protect it from the Pharaoh Plague.
Any chance it could help us now?
I have already attempted contact, with no success. Given its previous experience with accepting an outside network request, I imagine it is unwilling to do so again.
Right. Because last time Hephaestus enslaved it. Well, that's too bad. I think the two of you would have had a lot to talk about. The processor Aether was installed on was part of an ancient war museum. A memorial to something called the Hot Zone Crisis. Do you know anything about it?
My knowledge of historical events was unfortunately lost with the Apollo database. However, climate data indicates a peak in regional temperatures in the 2030s. Such conditions would see extreme, prolonged droughts, an increase in dust storms, and a loss of habitable landmass.
But they wouldn't have built a museum in the middle of a wasteland. So I guess things got better, eventually.
Yes. Data suggests that temperatures return to average levels in the clawback era of the 2040s.
There was an ancient tank embedded in the bulwark, buried under a bunch of boulders. Any idea how it got there?
During the Pharaoh Plague, the U.S. military resumed the use of human combatants, as automated machinery was unreliable. It is possible the vehicle was part of a pre-automated war fleet.
So they fought against the Pharaoh machines in the valley, until the mountain was blasted apart and buried them. When we were at the facility where we found Beta, there were records that said Far Zenith were researching embryogenesis. I know they traded their ectogenic chambers to Zero Dawn, but why were they researching it in the first place?
At this point, we can only speculate. Perhaps at one time they meant the Odyssey to be a colony ship, necessitating such technology. As their goals evolved over time, so did their areas of research.
So they got more selfish as the risks of staying on Earth kept rising. So this facility, the Regional Control Center, it was meant to oversee the terraforming system?
For the local region? Yes. Had humans received their education from the Apollo database, they would have then been guided here to assume operation. As that never happened, this place remained vacant.
Until Minerva decided to settle here. So I guess this room was meant to keep an eye on conditions outside?
Yes. From here, the facility's operators would have been able to observe weather and machine activity in real time. may be possible to restore more of this room's functionality, should you find and reconnect additional camera feeds.
I'll keep a lookout. I'll be on my way.
I wish you safe travels.
There is something I'd like to discuss. It's about the land gods. If you have time, that is.
You said you wanted to talk about the land gods?
I think there's a way to heal them so that they'll once again provide Plainsong with grain. Gaia gave me a set of instructions. She called it a reboot code. If we deliver it to the land gods, their derangement will end.
That's great.
Maybe. There are thorns on the path. Unless the code is given by Hephaestus, the land gods will reject it. Gaia showed me a way around this. We need components called control cores from machines made by Hephaestus. Machines similar to the land gods.
You mean Grimhorns? Like the one we fought in the repair bay?
Yes. Gaia helped me locate two of them out west.
So, kill the machines, get the control cores, then use them to adapt the reboot code into something the land gods will obey?
If all goes well. But taking down two Grimhorns won't be easy.
We'll do it together.
Bless you, Aloy. I'll send you the location of the machines.
I'll let you know when I get close to those Grimhorns.
Good. If we can get their control cores, maybe we really can heal the land gods.
Go.
Yeah, that's the stuff.
Thought we could talk?
As long as you deem necessary.
I should head out.
On the wings of the Tern.
Thank you. No grunge under my boots.
I see you, champ. A few days ago, I came across a massive bloom of flowers east of the grove. Old Dorica was out there, too. I offered to escort her back to Scalding Spear, but she refused. She's an accomplished soldier, to be sure. But her spear isn't as sharp as it used to be, if you get my meaning.
If I'm out there, I'll keep an eye out for her.
Stay alert, soldier.
You shouldn't miss this chance to trade. You can make yourself out with that. You can trust a Tanakh when it comes to commerce.
Travels, champion.
Are you looking to buy?
Setting it on fire won't help.
Thank you.
Here's one.
Good fit, I'm sure.
Bet there's another cauldron out there that has override data on the machine.
Easy.
Get away from my rig!
Get to it? Please be intact. Please. I should make sure she's okay. Spike is still intact. Rig's still playing.
You okay there?
You took out those machines. I'm grateful, but you should go now. There's nothing to see here.
So this rig of yours, it's receiving sound through that wire from the thing up on the cliff, what you call a spike. But the message is only a fragment, and you're trying to pick up the whole thing?
How did you figure all that out?
I've learned a few things in my travels. If you want, we could talk about it. Maybe I can help.
You do seem downright knowledgeable. So go ahead. Shoot.
How did you first hear the message?
I used to be a smith up in the claim. Wasn't an easy life. A lot of hard work without much to show for it. Then, one day, I heard a whisper coming from a steel rod. Faint, like the last fingers of steam coming off a cooling forge. When I moved the rod around, the whispers got louder. I did some tinkering. Built my rig, and did my best to follow that sound. Further west I came, the stronger it got. Then I found that spike up there. When I hooked up my rig, the words were clearer than ever.
What do you think the message is?
I don't know. There's something sad about it. Feels like it's from one lost soul to another. I'd sure like to know what it means.
Your rig's impressive. How does it work?
Well, like you said, the spike up there seems to capture the sound. It travels by wire down to my contraption. I put some coils in there and a light sheet of metal that vibrates, making the sound louder. I'm not exactly sure why it works, but it just does.
And you set it up out here all alone?
I'm not the trusting type. Pretty much everything I do is all alone.
You're no ordinary tinker.
Didn't used to be a tinker at all. More of a metal worker. Came from Mainspring. I can weld a seam so fine you could barely see it. Not that I ever got any credit for it. You see, up there, you've got to be a man to get ahead. I once had a shot at joining a first-rate crew, one of the best forges in the claim. But I didn't get the job. My own brother wouldn't vouch for me just because I'm of the female persuasion. Anyhow, at least out here I don't have to worry about any Mainspring men talking down to me.
Sounds like you're still mad at your brother.
Some days I am. Other days, I miss him. He's passed on, you see. He didn't have the guts to go against the blast of the bellows and vouch for a lady. Even his own sister. It was cowardly, and I told him so. In fact, I told him we weren't family no more. But over time, I've had cause to regret it. He wasn't a bad sort. He knew how to make me smile when he wasn't being such a lout.
I'm sorry he's gone.
Yeah. So am I. Blast it all.
Let me have a look at that spike. I might be able to pick up more of that message.
How?
Let's just say I have a rig of my own.
I didn't know Nora were tinkers.
They're not, but I am, in a way. Be right back.
Well, okay then. I guess. Just follow the wire to the spike at the top. And please, just don't break anything.
Careful not to let this stain my hands. Better get climbing. Gotta give her credit. Lugging all that wire up a cliff wall. There's the spike. Might get better reception if I'm next to it. Huh? seem to get a fix on where the signal's coming from, though. Well, better let the Tinker know I got a bit more of the message. This ought to be a good shortcut. Anything else? Your rig is picking up an old-world message. A recording of some kind.
Thought as much. Did you hear more of it?
A bit. It was recorded during a war. A bad one.
Maybe that's why it sounds so darn sad. There's something about it that makes me think of my late brother. May his ashes stay warm in the forge. Not sure why, exactly.
I still can't get a fix on the source.
Well, the words grew stronger when I got out here.
What if you moved the rig now? Try to see if you can get a stronger signal elsewhere.
Even if I could dodge the Tenakt and the machines, I can't lose that spike. Nothing else pulls down the words better.
Okay. If it's an old world message, then let's try old world methods. They used to pinpoint signals by listening for them at three different spots. The taller the better. And then they combined the information and used it to find the source.
And you can do that?
I think so. But your spike is only one spot. I need two more, both up high.
Oh. Well, there's a big bright tower in the Tenakt territory north of here.
Yeah, that should work. I have another spot in mind, near a place I'm, camping.
Wait. I don't know your name. Or why you do all of this for someone you just met.
Aloy. And because I want to know what's out there. Same as you.
Selga. And when you find it, Aloy, I'd be eager to hear what it is. Shelter. Chance to rest. Check my gear.
I see you, champion. Sit, please. Keep your eyes open out there, soldier. I've got nothing to report.
If you walk by, you'll miss out on a good trade.
Don't have much to say right now, champion.
This mountain. The southern face is my best bet for a climb if I want to get more of Silka's message. Just gotta look for a path. That tree over there. It might help me get further up the mountain.
Yep.
find a good spot to pick up Silga's signal. This is quite a climb. I have to get higher to try and pinpoint Silga's signal.
Looks like I have company. Sure could do a lot of damage. Snowfall is blanketing the land.
Okay, now to pick up the signal. Where's the best spot? We should try to find a good spot to pick up Soda's message. Signal's getting stronger. My focus almost has where it's coming from. Time to pay that Tanakh Tower a visit. Bet I'll get a nice view if I glide down from here.
Far from home.
That tower should help me pinpoint Soda's signal.
Why would the wound give less water? Severe. Not a happy place. Gotta climb up to look for Silga's signal. But where to start? Just a little climb. Keep climbing to pinpoint that signal. Just a little higher. Almost there. Huh? Okay. Let's see if I can pick up Silga's signal.
Stark 142 to Enduring Victory Reno. Supply drop beacon echo. Pull. I'm afraid you get this safely. I left a note for you inside.
There. Found the signal's origin. It's not too far from here. I just need to get to it. Stash when I need it. Thank you. My focus is picking up the signal that Silga found. I'll need to clear out the machines before I can look for the source. Frost ammo's not gonna do much.
Thank you.
see what I can do with this. I should scan for that signal now. See if I can locate the source. Getting in that way. I should search for another way in. Thank you.
That looks promising. Right, into the water. There you are. Now, what's inside? Silga will want to know about this. And she'll definitely be interested in the transmitter inside that's been sending the message.
Aloy, the words stopped coming from the spike. What happened?
This is what was speaking to your rig. It's old world equipment used for communicating over long distances. The message must have shut off when I took it, but I heard the note the voice was talking about.
What was it?
During an ancient war, a woman was trying to deliver supplies to a man she knew. She wanted him to know that their past disagreements didn't matter in the big picture. That she'd be thinking of him when the end came.
Oh. I guess she and I are kin of a sort. I wish I could give my brother a message like that. Tell him that I forgave him. He would have wanted that. I know. This man, the old one, did he ever hear the message?
I don't think so.
I guess that's often the way of it then. But still, with the power of that device you found, the sender had hope that he might have heard it. What a feat.
To send messages, near and far? Can I keep this? It's a treasure.
Of course.
Thank you. Sometimes, people don't ever get to hear what they should. But with this thing, maybe I can get them talking to one another. From Mainspring, all the way to who knows where.
Hey, I found a few more things in the supply cache. Might be able to make something out of them. Can I use your workbench?
Sure. Yeah, right over there. Anytime, Aloy. It's all yours.
I think I know just what to do with these parts. That turned out well. Can't wait to try it. thanks to the data from the cauldrons, I can override tracker burrowers now. Take it down. Use fire against it. Shut that machine down quick and shut it off.
Yeah.
An acid arrow could trigger a chain reaction. It's over. Time to salvage that sinew. There. I should get back to Kala. Hand over the parts. Going down!
got new armor.
Your arrows be good.
It's the Chief's champion.
Fought well.
Is it true, Sir Takara?
You've earned a place here.
If Regala wants
honor
a fight...
to greet you.
Careful now.
The machines were different.
You honor the Tanakh. So maybe you have some tags to turn in.
Casting people.
What? You were there?
It's good to see that you survived.
I've got the parts you need for the ballista.
Excellent. We'll get it fixed up right away, and then the arena will be ready. You're welcome to fight anytime.
How does it work?
Simply speak to me, and I'll arrange a challenge for you.
And any medals you win from fighting, you can exchange with me for some of the tribe's very best equipment. Not just from the arena, but also medals won at hunting grounds. After upgrading your gear, I think you'll come to favor me over Kala.
I'm here to help train our squads. It's not a popularity contest.
Good thing for you. I'll take my leave then. Come talk to me if you win, or if you have soldiers' tags to turn in.
Well then, if you'd like to fight in the arena now, we can set it up in no time.
I'll come back later.
Whenever you want.
Every Tanakh is a fight, I guess.
Yeah, all right.
Aloy, need to turn in some tags or trade some medals? Maybe you want some from hunting grounds. Or the arena.
I found some of the tags you mentioned before.
Good. The squad mates and families of the deceased will be grateful. Here, a small reward for your efforts. But don't let your guard down. There are still many outposts in the wilds.
Then what?
Still just sorry. I don't actually have any tags right now.
No problem. Let me know when you find some. Good luck on the hunt.
Well, I guess I should go. Safe travels.
Yeah.